welcome back to my channel, Happy Artist. This is another one of those beginner's tutorials because there are so many of us out there and we're all looking for tips and tricks and trying to figure out how these pours look so beautiful on the groups that we're on, and yet when we try them, they don't turn out the same way, right? This is your very simple bottom of a soda bottle pour. The first tip when it comes to this technique, again, as every single other technique, is consistency. I'm hammering on this in every single video because it's hardly ever mentioned how your consistency needs to be on the thick side, on the thin side, where do we need to be? And then they start talking about the ratios of what they used for that specific pour. You try and use the same ratios, but you're using different brands, different paints altogether, and you don't get the same reaction. So consistency is key. The next tip is using the bottom of the soda bottle sized in proportion with your canvas. I'm using one of the smaller ones because I'm working on a smaller canvas, a practice canvas. Should you be working on a much larger canvas, you might want to use like a 2-liter bottle or even go larger than that, and it doesn't need to necessarily be the bottom of a soda bottle. It just depends on how many places the paint is going to pour onto the canvas that it will create different patterns. And you could use it as a butterfly effect, you could use it for flowers, depends what you're going for. So this first one I did, oh, and I hope you laugh with me on this one, I did not secure my canvas to the spinning table. So I poured everything and was very happy and ready, and watch what happens. So, when you're using a spinning table, if you've not watched any of my previous videos when I talk about the spinning table, make sure that you have got protection under the surface you're working on the floor, and up against any furniture as well. Because you have absolutely no idea where that paint is going to splatter, and it really doesn't need to be on a wall, a cupboard, or furniture. A quick tip, don't start pouring on a dry canvas, like what I've done in my previous one. Because then, as you see, when you lift the soda bottom bottle, it's going to leave a gap that you now need to fill. So like what I've done here, you rather want to make sure that you first got enough paint just to cover the inside of your soda bottle bottom. Some extra tips while you're pouring. Try to make sure that you keep a constant pour right in the middle of the soda bottom. If you don't, you will see that you give more paint on one side than the other. And if you're looking for something that needs to be symmetrical, it's going to be quite difficult to picture afterwards. And something just to create that seamless look from the inside into the rest of the pour, if you're wanting to go ahead and do something like that, would be to use that same color that you used in the middle, right at the end. Like what you see, I've done the black twice. Now you can go ahead and spin. I have now secured the canvas to the spinning table with a little bit of masking tape. It doesn't take much. everything spun out. I was just going for anything that happened. I really wasn't looking for a symmetrical flower sort of look. So I'm actually really enjoying these lines that have just spun off the sides of the canvas. What have you tried when it comes to the soda bottle bottoms? Let me know in the comment section below. Super easy one and lots of fun. One of those that you can pretty much do with the entire family. I hope you enjoyed that and that the tips do help when you try this technique. Have a magical day. Ciao for now. This is your simple soda bottom pour. Soda bottom, just depending on how many places the pour, how many places, put a slight bit amount of your soda bottle bottom. Say that faster. Of paint in the inside of the soda bottle, bottom bottle. On the inside of the soda bottom bottle. My word!